Howdy everyone, and welcome back to more Clannad. We've just finished doing a fire, and now she wants to know where we're going. To the copier. She'd make a bunch and go around putting them up after school. I think that's the most we could do today.
Hi!
After that, we use the copier in the teacher's room and then head home. I return to class, find Sunohara seated, gripping his own head. What's wrong now? Oh, cheer up.
Genki nai no dare no se ska ne?
Guy sitting in front of you?
Anta da! Omae da! Kisama da! Mii da!
You just find yourself at the end there. You do know that, right?
Naru ka, aho!
An idiot just called me an idiot. Blind leading the blind here.
Shonichi ni kutte.
Oh my gosh, the train, I swear. What would you do if I got to eat one?
何の計画してたら?
What would you do? Tell me. In English, please.
Kill me!
You're a real scary guy, you know that?
食い物の恨みはそれだけ恐ろしいってことさ。
Don't get too depressed over it, okay?
そりゃ。お前が新商品を食ったかどうかによるな。
I didn't, so don't worry. Live on, my friend.
なんだ、食ってないのかよ。
No, I didn't.
なら今回は許しておいてやるよ。ま、命は大切にな。
I ought to be telling you that.
あ、食いたかった。
He puts his face back down and goes back to grumbling.
Okazaki-kun.
Who's this person? Yeah? As I sit down, the class president begins to talk to me.
Mo, doko ni mo ikanai desu ka?
I won't go anywhere.
Hontou desu ka?
She's the girl who kept yelling at me every time I left with Sunohara. I just told you, I won't. Why'd she have to ask me something like that, and why is she being so pushy about it?Oh, worksheets. Are these from homeroom?
Hi.
Thank you. Why is it in a lot of anime and BMs, I guess, the class president is always someone who's kind of shy and introverted? Doesn't that seem to kind of go against the being a leader? I mean, I assume the class president's like a leader of sorts, right? So it just seems like weird qualities to have to some, for someone who's, you know, the class president. I don't know.Maybe it's just me. I reach my hand out to get the worksheets from Fujibashi. Fujibashi, that's funny. Fujibashi. Otherwise, I stay slumped over. In one fell swoop, I grab the worksheets and cram them into my desk. Do you need something? You're kind of looking at me funny. No, it's not nothing. Tell me.She returns to her seat with her shoulders drooped. I sigh as I rest my head in my hands and look out the window. Thoughts pass through my mind. Like, what do we have next period again? Sunohara is still dejected even after class ends. So I leave without him. It's okay, I didn't like him much anyway. I head to the drama club room.Oh, is that a real Somi? Ooh, nice. I didn't come here in any particular rush, but... I don't see Furukawa. What's she doing? She does seem pretty slow. Oh, well. I wait, but she does not show. Where the hell is she? Bored eyes scribble on the edge of the blackboard. Day duty, Nagisa Furukawa.I finish scribbling and write, wait a while longer, but she still is nowhere to be seen. Maybe something happened? I start to feel a little worried, not gonna lie. Should we look for her? Or should we wait? Yeah, let's go look for her. Ah, she's hopeless. Don't tell me that she accidentally went to the class next door or something. Ugh, I could see her doing that. Yeah, let's look in the classroom. Probably went off somewhere else. Take a peek inside. Seems like no one's around. I open the door. I assumed the room would be empty. It apparently is not. But a young female student sits near the windows. Who's that? My god. She's born without a mouth. Oh shit, how sad. That's just really small. The sunlight pouring in prevents me from getting a clear look at her face, leaving only her silhouette visible. Really, I can see a pretty good look at her face right now. She's carving a block of wood with a knife. Her concentration seems to have erased my existence completely from her senses. There's something irresistibly cute about the way she's working so hard on it. For a while, I just stand there, watching. Oh, she saw me. Her hands stop as she finally notices my presence. Her eyes meet mine. She freezes. What's wrong? Suddenly, she jumps up and runs towards the corner of the room. She reminds me of a cat caught trying to steal food. Except a cat probably wouldn't be clutching a knife the whole time. I mean, Garfield might, but he's not real. Note to self, don't surprise the girl with the knife. You may end up getting stabbed. Holding her ground, she cautiously watches my every move, as still as can be. I find it funny wondering if she's trying to hide by standing perfectly still. Better yet, she's in the corner of the room, effectively the most visible spot in the whole place. Well, then what should I do now? Let's talk to her. Curious to know what she has to say. Say, is this the art club's room? Hey, I'm talking to you. She reluctantly points a finger at herself and tilts her head to the side. Yeah, you. As if there's anyone else here. She raises her index finger. Maybe she wants me to repeat the question. Is this the art club's room? Nandeska Art Club. Still standing tightly in the corner, she shakes her head nervously. Oh, right. The club members would be here as if it was. So, do you just skip too many art classes and end up with piles of homework or something like that? She shakes her head again. Then it's just a hobby? She shakes her head again. And then just what on earth are you doing here?
これですか?
She shows me the wooden block she was working on, holding it in front of her chest. Yeah, that.
これは大好きなですね。
Oh my god, look how happy she is that she's holding a wooden star. Aww. So happy, look at that face! That is the face of pure bliss right there. Suddenly she has a euphoric look on her face. It's as if she's lost in a reverie, dreaming up something really fabulous. She's so full of openings. With a few quick steps, I quickly close the distance between the two of us, and proceed to take the knife from her hand. Relax, I'll give it back. Isn't it kind of dangerous using a knife like this? Now that I'm closer, I can see a bandage covering one of her hands. From the intense look she's giving me, I can tell she wants her knife back. You know, you should stop using this thing. It's not good for you. What? Your hand. I can tell it's a mess. It's carrying. Is carving wood really worth cutting yourself up like that?
やりたいんです。放っておいてください。
Katie's got some claws.
それ、返してください。
Doesn't your hand hurt, though?
痛くないです。
You're lying. Liar.
念のため、巻いてるだけです。
No, it's not. Well then, shake my hand.
はい。
I put a bit of strength into my grip. In a flash, she pushes me away and her distance reverts back to what it was before I took the knife. She's squatting down the opposite corner now. Looks like that really hurt. A few moments pass.
痛くなかったです。
You're lying! You're a horrible liar! On the verge of tears, she stands back in front of me.
返してください。
No! Do we shake hands again?
ダメです。
Why?
もうダメです。一回握手しました。握手はたくさんするもんじゃないです。
Okay, that makes sense. In that case, how about high five?
ハイタッチ。
ハイタッチ。You know, like in sports, when a player scores a point or something, their teammate raises a hand and they clap them together in the air. It seems really ridiculous when you have to spell it out like that, you know? It's like, why do we ever do something that stupid?
シュート決めてないです。
Okay, then let's pretend we do. Okay, here goes. I awkwardly take a free throw pose and toss the air ball towards an imaginary basket. And it's good! Come on, raise your hand!
はい。
Clap.It's less of a high five and more of a... just a straight slap, really. Once again, she pushes me back and runs towards the opposite corner. Should have heard more than the handshake. We were literally hitting each other's hand. A few moments pass.
痛くなかったです。
Stop lying! She stood before me with the trail of tears on her face.
返してください。
And like a handshake, we can do a high five as many times as we like.And it's in there! Now raise your hand.
Hi.
Oh my god, is this going anywhere? There she goes again. That's what I've been telling you. Stop carving until your hand's completely healed. Put the knife into my pocket.
返してください!
No. She just won't give up. What if someone were trying to enjoy their club activities in peace nearby? If something happens to you in here, do you know how much trouble that caused them?
隣、誰もいなかったはずです。
Club season's coming up. People are going to start using the rooms around here. That's why you should be patient until your injury heals. Besides, you can't make a decent carving with your hand in that condition, right? I don't know why you're pushing yourself so hard, but it'd be better if the final product is in perfect condition, right?
でも、手を休めてる暇なんてないんです。
The teacher who gave you this assignment must be a real tyrant.
違います。自分で思いついたことです。
Oh.Then there's no problem. Just give your hand a rest for a bit. With that said, I leave the classroom. Boy, I really regret going in there. Think of all the other stuff we could have done. From the corridor, I look back into the classroom. She's still standing there, looking down helplessly on her half-finished work of art. Her tears are about to burst out. Maybe that was a bit too mean? Nah. I'm only an idiot would try to carve with a hand like that.Better care of your body. If you're working an injury, it could lead to permanent damage that you'll regret the rest of your life. I understand that better than anyone. Rotating my shoulder, I look out the window. Naturally, my eyes wander gradually lower. And there she is. God, what is she doing? Does she think it's a slunce or something? I wouldn't put it past her. Sheesh!Climb down the stairs and head to the courtyard. She's sitting in our usual lunch spot. I approach her. Hey, you know it's not lunch break. What are you doing here? We got club stuff to do. Furukawa's holding a bamboo broom, spinning its handle around in her hand. She sits without a word. From the looks of it, she's down again.What's wrong? Did something happen? I sit next to her. Sand gets caught on the bamboo broom's tip as she continues spinning it in front of her feet. So it's your turn on class cleaning duty, eh?
Hi.
She finally answers. So what's wrong? Why aren't you cleaning?
してました。
You were you? So why'd you stop?
ですね、
Why'd you stop?
それは…
Why did you stop? Yeah, I yelled at you. Sorry. She stops and she quickly stands up.
岡崎さんに話すようなことではないです。
Jeez. What the hell? She's mad at me. What'd I do? Hey, hold on! I get up too and follow after. I don't get you, you know that? You're weird. You're not gonna treat me like a bad guy?
違います。岡崎さんはいい人です。
You don't have to go so far as to call me a good person. But I'm the kind of person who'd harm you, right?
そうです。
You can just tell me what's wrong like you always do.
私、岡崎さんを巻き込んじゃっています。
What?
面白くもないことに。岡崎さんの貴重な時間を 無駄にさせちゃっています。
That's not true. It's plenty fun. Having a blast. Well, maybe I shouldn't say that. No, I'm sorry, I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I just gaze at her. All of a sudden, I feel uncomfortable. I feel another me. One that's less attached to the situation, watching us as this takes place. What am I doing? I lose track of time just for a moment. As this happens, Furukawa just looks down at the ground, ever silent. For now, I need to focus on cheering her up. Food, that's right, food. Food will cheer her up. I start thinking of different kinds of food. What is it? What is that she likes? The Big Dango family? Back when the song was popular, every supermarket he walked into had huge packs of Dango, made to look just like characters. Furukawa, you like Dango, don't you?
Hi.
Then say the words Big Dango family for me. Use that to cheer yourself up.
Dango Daikazoku, uttemasu deshouka?
Probably, but don't worry about that right now. So just say the words and use them as your mantra. Furukawa closes her eyes, and then...
Dango Daikazoku!
She says the words without conviction. So, feel more calm?
Hi.
After she opens her eyes, she seems a little bit more positive, relaxed. Like whatever was bothering her loosened its grip just a bit. You can tell me what happened later, alright? For now, let's just do what you need to do.
Hi!
She grabs a broom in her hands and walks off. The Big Dango family seems to have a miraculous effect on her. I watch her as she fades out of view. Later on, Furukawa and I go around posting flyers on billboards around school. Club recruitment, a full month late. Since the cut-off period for most clubs has already come and gone, though, our announcement stands out on its own. Finally, we place a flyer on the last remaining billboard. I stand there and stare at it for a moment, moved. Furukawa is next to me, still a little lethargic. Well, wanna go buy a Big Dango family and head home? I move him away from the billboard to try to cheer up. Alrighty, everybody. Let's find out what Tamayo's gonna ask her next time on Conad. Take it easy, everybody.